You may have heard about smart materials. Well, I want to talk to you about one particular smart material called memory metal. It's a special kind of metal that has some really exciting properties. Let's try an experiment to look and see what they can do. Let me give you one of these straight wires and bend it around your finger and make it into a coil. We'll just take this coil and set it down on the table. Now, let's get some hot water. So you probably know that materials display different behavior when they're hot versus when they're cold. So why don't you pick up your wire, and the hot water is very hot, so don't touch it, and throw the wire in the water and see what happens. Wow, they all became straight. So here's our coils turned into straight wires. Well, what's going on here is sort of an atomic ballet down at the nanoscale. And this atomic ballet is a phase transformation. And you've probably heard about a phase transformation before between gases and liquids and solids. Well, this is a kind of phase transformation that happens between two different solids. So if we have the wire in this phase and we bend it around our finger, it stays bent. But if we have the other phase of the wire, it actually has really different properties. In this phase, it's very, very springy. It won't stay bent. So what's going on? Well, some people describe this as an atomic ballet. In this particular metal, there are nickel atoms and titanium atoms. And they have two different arrangements depending on whether they're cold or whether they're hot. And in this particular case, we're seeing a phase change between two different solid phases. So we have a hot phase and a cold phase. This is the cold phase, and then there's a little atomic ballet shuffle to get to the hot phase when we go through the phase transformation. Well, we can actually control what temperature this phase change happens at, depending on the composition of the material, exactly how much nickel and how much titanium we have, and the heat treatment of the material. This plot tells us about how the transformation temperature varies with the composition and exactly how much nickel and titanium is in the particular alloy. When we have some compositions, we get very low transformation temperatures, and at other compositions, we get very high transformation temperatures. Well, it turns out there's all kinds of applications for this memory metal, and you may actually know somebody with memory metal in their mouth. And that memory metal is actually used in orthodontic dental arch wires. It's for these braces here. It's also used in other medical device applications like in stents that are used to treat cardiovascular disease and like in the flex frame glasses that I was showing you. So if you happen to sit on your glasses, you don't actually break them. They just pop back to their original shape after you realize you sat on them. There's some other clever uses of nickel titanium, and one of them was made by an Italian designer. So this Italian designer wove cloth out of very fine wire of nickel titanium, and he made a shirt out of it. And what's special about this shirt is, when it's hot outside, it automatically rolls up its sleeves. Kind of a silly application, but you can do lots of different things with memory metal. And it's because of this atomic ballet that happens down at the nanometer scale. We'll be right back.